Good morning, students. Last class, you learned about the lesson Introduction to Euclid Geometry. In that, you learned the axioms, postulates, their definitions, differences, and different axioms and different postulates. Now, using these axioms and postulates, we have to solve the exercise. So, let us go to the first exercise, that is from the lesson Introduction to Euclid Geometry. Here, the first main. While doing this exercise, open your textbook, keep open your textbook, and whatever I will show here, the question will be available in the textbook. Go through the question, and this one you have to write in the notes. Now, first thing is, you have to say the statement is true or false. The first statement is, only one line can pass through a single point. Through a single point, you can draw only one line. The statement is false, because through a single point you can draw many number of lines. So there can be infinite number of lines can be drawn through a single point. So hence the statement is false. Now go to second statement. There are infinite number of lines which pass through two distinct points. Two points, through two points you can draw a infinite number of lines. That is also false, because through two points you can draw only one line segment. One line segment requires two points. So two distinct points, there can be only one line segment can be drawn. So the statement is false. Now third one, a terminated line can be produced indefinitely in both sides. This statement is true, because a terminated line means there should be two end points. You can extend these end points indefinitely and you can make the line as a straight line. Next is, if two circles are equal, then their radius is equal. The statement is true. Why? Because two circles are coincide each other means there should be radius must be equal. So if they have two equal radii, then the two circles are equal. And the last one is, in the figure AB is PQ and PQ is XY. Then AB is XY. This is your axiom 1. Axiom 1, things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. So this statement is true, because AB and PQ are equal, PQ and XY are equal, therefore AB and XY are also equal. So these are the statements we have to say true or false. Now let us go to next main. Next main, that is second main. Second main is, give a definition for each of the following terms. Here some terms are given, for that we have to write the definition. Before that, our other terms are needed to define first. What they are, you might have defined them. So, it is given that we have to define parallel lines, intersecting lines, or perpendicular lines. But to define this, first of all, we have to define a sum statement. Yes, there are other terms that should be defined first. What are those? They are a plane. This one you all learned in your previous class. Plane means what? Plane means a leveled place. Leveled place is called as a plane. Next, we have to define a point. What is your point? Point is just a dot. It cannot be subdivided into parts. And one more is line. Line means it is a collection of points. A line segment is made up of different points, collection of points. Using these three things, we can define the following. These things we have to define, students. What are parallel lines? What are parallel lines? This one you learned in your lower classes. Parallel lines. Parallel lines means what? Two lines which will not meet each other if you extend them to any length. They are called as parallel lines. Parallel lines are those lines which never intersect each other and are always at a constant distance perpendicular to each other. Parallel lines can be two or more parallel lines also we can draw. Next one is perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines means what? Perpendicular lines means two lines will intersect each other. For example, if I take these two chalk pieces, these are the two lines. If I intersect these two lines, these are not perpendicular, but if they intersect at right angle, 90 degree, then such lines are called as a perpendicular lines. So two lines intersect at right angles, then they are called as a perpendicular lines. Next is a line segment. This you know already. What do you mean by line segment? It is a line which has starting point and a end point, or which is having two end points. That is called as a line segments. Next one is radius of a circle. Radius of a circle means what? You know, whenever you draw a circle, you will take some radius and you will draw a circle. So radius means what? The distance from the center to any point on the circle. That is called as a radius of a circle. Next one is square. This you all of you know. It is a quadrilateral in which all sides are equal and all angles are equal to 90 degree. It is called as square. Now, let us move on to third question. Here, third question, consider the two postulates given below. Here, two postulates are given. That is, given any two distinct points A and B, there exists a point C which is in between A and B. Means there are two points A and B. In between there is a point C. And next one is, there exist at least three points that are not on the same line. There are three points that are not on the same line. We have to discuss about these two postulates and we have to answer the question. Do these postulates contain any undefined term? Yes, they contain undefined term. What is undefined term? There it is mentioned that C is a point on AB, but it is not mentioned that C is the midpoint or it lies where it lies. It is not mentioned. So, it is called as an undefined term. They are undefined terms. Next, are these postulates are consistent? Yes, these postulates, if we consider the postulates, these are not the postulate exactly, they are the axioms. Do they follow Euclid postulate? They will not follow Euclid postulate because they are the axioms, because it is not only applicable to geometry, it is applicable to any part of mathematics. So, they do not follow Euclid postulate, they follow some other thing. Now, let us move on to some of the questions. There are two direct questions. That is the fourth question. You can see the picture here, you can see the figure. See the figure clearly and read the question. If a point C lies between two points A and B, if you see A and B are the two points and C is a point lies in between A and B, such that AC is BC. Means C is the midpoint in this case, AC is equal to BC. We have to prove that AC is half of AB. We have to prove AC is half of AB. One part of this is half of AB. We know that it is a midpoint, means it is half of AB itself, but we have to prove. So how to prove that? Here in the question it is given that AC is equal to BC. It is given. Now what I will do means I will add AC to both sides of this equation. So what this will become? AC plus AC is equal to BC plus AC. Now AC plus AC means what? It is 2AC. 2AC is equal to BC plus AC. What is BC plus AC, students? BC plus AC is nothing but AB. So it is 2AC is equal to AB. Now shift to 2 to that side. AC is equal to half of AB. That we have to prove. We prove this. In the question 4, point C is called the midpoint of the line segment. In this figure, point C is not there. Prove that every line has a line segment has only one and one midpoint. So we have to prove only one midpoint is there in the line segment. For that, we have to take two midpoints, that is P and Q. We will consider P and Q, both are the midpoints of the line segment. At the end, we have to prove both are not a midpoint. There is a single midpoint. So, if I take P is a, AB is a line segment and we have assumed that P and Q are the different midpoints of AB. Now, P and Q are the midpoints. Therefore, what happens? AP is equal to PB. Now, see, only P from AB plus AP is equal to PB plus AB. Equals are added to the equals, then the wholes are also equal. So we can say 2AP is equal to PB plus AP is equal to AB. So 2AP is equal to AB. In the same way, if we take Q is the midpoint, then AQ plus QB is equal to AB. So AQ I'll add, that time 2AQ is equal to AB I'll get. So 2AB is equal to AB, 2AQ is also equal to AB. According to the axiom, if the right hand side are equal, I can say left hand side are also equal. So I can say 2AB is equal to AQ. I'll divide both by 2, so it will become AP is equal to AQ. If AP is equal to AQ, can I say it is a different points? No, they are not the different points. AP is equal to AQ means P and Q are one and the same point. So thus we conclude that P and Q are the same point. So we can say there is only one midpoint for every line segments. Now next question. You can see the figure here. In the figure, AC is equal to BD. AC is equal to BD. Then we have to prove that AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CD we have to prove. Now, AC is equal to BD is given. Now, what we will do means, AC means what? AC is divided into two parts, that is AB and BC. So, AC I will write AB plus BC. In the same way, BD is BC plus CD. So, BD is BC plus CD. AC is equal to BD. Therefore, can I say these two are also equal? That is, Euclid's axiom. We can say that AB plus BC is equal to BC plus CD. Now, you can see BC is common here. So, what I'll do is, I'll remove BC from this. So, I'll subtract BC from both the equations. BC, BC gets cancelled. What is the remaining? Remaining is AB is equal to CD. You have to prove that AB is equal to CD. Hence, it is proved. Now, move on to next question. It is the last postulate. That is you. Why is axiom 5 is called as a universal truth? What is axiom 5? Axiom 5 is the whole is greater than a part. It is called as a universal truth. Why it is called a universal truth? So, if you take one paper or one chalk piece, whatever it may be, one whole thing, or if you take one dosa, it is a whole thing. If you divide that dosa into different parts, if you compare the part and the whole thing, that is equal. It is, whole is greater than the part. So, if you take anything and divide it into parts, the whole thing is always greater than the part. So, this is called as a universal truth. If you take one cake, here I took an example of cake, you can take anything. If you take a cake and if you divide into parts, if you compare the parts and the cake, the whole cake is always greater than the part. So, it is called a universal truth. Let us continue in next class, students. Thank you.